Welcome to Realty Juggler and our regular Wednesday webinar. Our topic today is importing data. There are many types of data that you'll want to import into Realty Juggler. The most important, of course, is your contact records. Whether you're going to be keeping track of them in your own spreadsheet or are exporting them from another CRM, or simply been using your email account to keep track of your client information, you'll want to get that information into Realty Juggler. If you have one or more of the more standard types of files to import, you can go to the main settings import screen. So here from main, we'll go into settings and then to import. Here you can select what database you want to import into. You can also select the format, which is different for each of the file types that you see here. So here for contacts, you can see the types of files we can import. And then for prospects, you can see that there's a different list. This link, Quick Transfer Instructions, has a list of export instructions from some of the more common CRM programs, as well as email accounts that people typically need to export from. So you can go ahead and click on the one that you need and follow the instructions to export from that data source. One thing to be clear about is that the type of file that is directly importable by RealtyJuggler is a CSV file. CSV stands for comma separated values. This is a spreadsheet file that can be opened by any spreadsheet program. Most people use Excel, but you can open this file with other spreadsheet programs such as Numbers. When you export your data from your data source, you should immediately save it and not open it. If you open it with Excel, chances are that you will tend to save it in the default format for that program, which for Excel is either a .xls or .xlsx. Of course, from the Save menu in Excel, you can save it in another type of file, such as CSV, but you will need to select that type of file from the format drop-down menu. So it's a lot easier to save the file rather than open it and then save it from Excel. Okay, so if CSV is the type of file, why is there a menu of file types? The reason for this has to do with the header in that spreadsheet file. In the first row of the spreadsheet are column labels. Each column has to have a unique label to let RealtyJuggler know what is in that column of data. Also, if RealtyJuggler doesn't understand the label, the label needs to be changed to one that it can understand. Or if there's no header, one needs to be added. To make that header conversion easier for types of files that aren't already on the standard list of files, we have a Valet import feature. We don't expect agents to be great at spreadsheets, so if you have a type of file that you can't import, go here from the main settings and then into the Valet import screen. We ask a couple of questions about your data. Generally, if it's on this list, you'll be able to import it normally using the regular importer. If it isn't on that list, go ahead and let us know where the data came from. I'll pick other and then type where the data came from. I'm going to go ahead and call it MLS Red, because that's where it came from. I'll then choose where to put the data. I'll go ahead and pick contacts. If I've already got records in the system, some of what I'm going to be importing might be duplicated. I can go ahead and choose how the records are imported. The safest is to not import duplicates, but there are occasions where one of the other options will come in handy, such as when I want to go ahead and merge two different types of records that both have, or two different data files that have notes that I'll want to go ahead and have from both of them, or a source that may have phone numbers and email addresses, and the other one may have phone numbers and a mailing address. Import frequency is cool because if you need to regularly import this type of file, say it is a farm list you need to import frequently, choose that option. With this option selected, we'll not only import your file, but we'll create an importer that you can use to re-import this type of file without having to use the Valet importer. The category field is so that I can give the records a category within RealtyJuggler, even if the records I'm importing don't have a category. If there's a category column in the file I'm importing, this category will be added to it. Records can have multiple categories. In this case, I just want to add the category Buyer Prospects. Now I select the file. My screen shows a Choose File button, but depending on which browser you're using, it may say Browse. After I pick the file, I have the opportunity to add notes. If I have special instructions for RealtyJuggler, then I'll go ahead and click the import button. I'll go ahead and I'll receive an auto reply email, so I'll know that my request was received. So let's pretend for a moment that I've submitted this request, my import was accomplished, and I've received an email from RealtyJuggler letting me know it was done. Let's take a look. When I go back to the RealtyJuggler import screen, for context, you can see that I have a new import option at the bottom of the format list. So the next time I need to import from my MLS, I can do that here on the main settings import screen. I'm going to go ahead and add both the category I want. And July to let them know that it's this month's worth of data. Then I'll go ahead and select the file and import it. Now when I go into my contacts, I can go ahead and see that those buyer prospect records were imported. Let's go to questions. Our topic for next week is rentals and the homes database and how to use them. If you haven't signed up for a free trial, go to realtyjuggler.com and click on the free trial button for no strings attached, 90-day free trial.